Thank you very much, Master of Ceremonies. His Excellency Anthony Thomas Aquinas Carmona, Order of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago and Senior Counsel, President of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago, Chancellor of the University of Trinidad and Tobago, and Sir, you have been accorded two hats. Allow me also to give you a third, Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of Trinidad and Tobago, Sir. Dr. The Honorable Lovell Francis, Minister of State in the Ministry of Education, learned judges, members of the Diplomatic Corps, enlightened professors, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, Admiral Kelschel, sir, and fellow sailors, faculty and students of the University of Trinidad and Tobago, and members of the media, a pleasant good morning to you all. I am indeed very humbled to be asked to deliver remarks on behalf of the Chief of Defense Staff. As academic staff here will tell you, to remark a script is sometimes a very daunting endeavor in light of what has been presented. Allow me first then to crave your indulgence to be brief. Our collective wisdom reminds us that if you show me who your friends are, I can tell you who you are. When one looks at the audience here this morning, the diverse and enlightened minds that are gathered here today, and peruses the program that is ambitious at the very least and gracious at the very best over the next 2 days, we can certainly see that ocean governance is indeed a matter for serious minds, but for friends and colleagues. The Chief of Defense Staff is very pleased to have the Trinidad and Tobago Coast Guard partner with the University of Trinidad and Tobago in this endeavor. The words governance as well as sovereignty ring almost on the same sides of the coin. We are indeed happy to participate, open to many new ideas, and Professor Imber, I will inform you that Mr. Aboud has sat down here very quietly while you were speaking, and I also want to make mention of his presence here for your benefit, sir. And in this endeavor, we would like to state as the Trinidad and Tobago Coast Guard that we are still learning how to discharge the role and function that this nation, and also by extension the international community, places on our shoulders. Allow me then to very humbly congratulate the organizers who have put together many hours of persuasion, hard work, time behind the scenes to bring this together and to look forward to the next 2 days. I thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.